Okay, let's have a quick look here. I have a simple PCB project which I've called SBC552. It's just a simple two-sheet design of a single board computer for an 80C552 microcontroller, very common 8051 derivative used in the automotive industry. This is a general purpose computer board, so pretty much all of the IOs for the chip are going to headers which can plug into other PCBs. In fact, I've designed the board so this could be used as a mezzanine card in an overall system. This underlying sheet here is a hierarchical sub-block. If I control double click on that, you can see the preview automatically comes up without even clicking. Just by hovering the mouse over it, I get a preview of what's underneath it, but if I control double click, it opens the underlying document. Here's the logic necessary for all the memory mapping. Now, what I wanted to do is illustrate how this all works with version control, and also how to pull in a 3D mechanical model for a component or some object on the board and link all that up and then do a revision update. What you'll see is beside every document that's in the project, even the output job file, even the project libraries, everything is atomically stored or glued together within the same project folder. And all of these items, even the data sheets, I've added those to the project. I don't really have to do that, but I wanted to, so there they are. They're all linked into version control, and you can see the version control status for these documents down the side here with the little green check mark, meaning that my local working copy is all up to date. Now, just to show you how I've set everything up here, there's one document there that's been modified since. Just to show you how all that's set up, if I go to Preferences and Version Control, at the moment I'm just using Subversion, even though I could use any of these other systems. Subversion is probably the easiest and most flexible system to get up and running. Now, I have that running as the client on my local machine, but my version control repository is all set up using XAMPP. Now, let me show you how that works. I'm just going to open up a web browser instance here, and I'll bring that across. So here's my web browser, and if I go to localhost, which is my own computer, this is the loopback address. I'll provide my own root password for that. This is where I've run the installation for XAMPP, which is the open source package for Apache, MySQL, and PHP running on Windows. XAMPP can run, of course, on Linux or various different forms of other operating systems as well. I'm running it on my own local machine. So I've set this up for pretty much just for Apache and also some PHP stuff I'm doing separately. Now, once I've got that set up, I've also added Subversion. And if I just bring up a Windows Explorer session here, I can go to my hard disk, and on my hard disk here, I've set up a folder called SVN Repos. Within that, I've set up another subfolder called HTTP repo, and for each Subversion over Apache, I guess you'd say web-based Subversion repository, all I need to do is create a new folder in here. I might call this Project X, and then within Project X I can right click and just use Tortoise SVN to create a brand new repository locally in that directory. Now, because I've already set up, so there it is, that's all the private parts for the repository. Now, because I've already set up this path on my hard disk here as an Apache Subversion path, that's all I have to do, and now I instantly have, and I can prove it to you, that one I've just added there, Project X, I instantly have a brand new repository available via HTTP. So let's go to HTTP localhost, and these are under the Apache paths SVN. Actually, let me try that again in my other web browser instance. Let me just switch over to that. Don't know what happened to that. I think I closed it. I must have closed it. Actually, you know what's more fun? I can even access it in Altium Designer. So let me do it here. HTTP localhost /svn/project x. And that invokes Explorer, and it shows me I have a new repository that's completely empty and it's currently at revision zero. So you can create, you know, once you've set up Apache and SVN, which is a whole other topic, it becomes very, very quick and easy to add new repositories for new projects that you may be doing. So